Today we will show in this video how to debug M4 firmware with Linux running on A7. Debug is done with STM32 Cube IDE on STM32 MP1 product. In STM32 Cube IDE, we will compile the XTI GPIO project example from the STM32 Cube MP1 package, and we will show how to debug the M4 firmware while Linux is running. We will illustrate how Linux loads into the MCU RAM the M4 firmware and starts its execution. We are going to open and build the project to get the M4 ELF binary. See in this wiki page the tree organization of this STM32 MP1 package. It provides the IP ALT drivers and a multitude of MP1 firmware examples. As we have just seen in the debug configuration, there is two ways of debugging. The engineering mode is for development phase of the M4 firmware without Linux. Debug in so-called production mode allows M4 debugging while the firmware is interacting with Linux. In engineering mode, the boot pins are set to engineering mode. In this case, the ROM code is not started. The M4 is loaded and started through the JTAG probe. In production mode, the boot pins are set so that the loader will start Linux. When we click on the debug icon in Cube IDE, the M4 firmware is loaded in the Linux file system via a SSH connection. Then Linux loads it in the MCU RAM and starts its execution. Ultimately, the STM32 Cube IDE GDB will attach to the STM32 debug port on a running M4 firmware. In this lab, we will use this configuration. The firmware GPIO XTI will toggle an orange LED on or off via GPIO upon a DK2 user button press via an XTI interrupt. Before starting this M4 firmware, we have to start Linux with M4 example device tree. This kernel configuration reserves exclusively for M4 an XTI interrupt and a GPIO. This configuration prevents Linux from using or stopping the clock of these two IP in stop mode. We check at the bottom right status widget in the Cube IDE that the virtual COM port staging connection is green. We open the UART console by clicking on the butterfly icon. In this console, we write reboot to reboot Linux and select number 3 in the uBoot menu to select the right device tree. Let's initiate the debug session. First, we check production mode is selected in the debug configuration. Here, we use Ethernet over USB using a cable plugged on the DK2 OTG USB port. We check in the Kube IDE at the bottom right status widget that the IP address is green. It means that the SSH connection between the PC and the board is functional. Click on the debug icon to start the debug session. Click on the pause icon. It will attach GDB. And observe M4 is halted in the main function in the core while loop. You can check if you press the user 1 button that the orange LED does not switch on. Click in pause icon, the M4 firmware execution resumes. If you press on the user button, the orange LED shall be switched on. The loader script Kube IDE uses the firmware Cortex M4 loader script to load and start or stop the M4 firmware. The script copies the firmware ELF into the RemoteProc loader directory. Then the script sets the name of the ELF in the RemoteProc Linux loader. Then it launches the ELF loading and execution. Let's see how it works. We will stop the debug session. We will open a console on the target and check the current status of the execution of the firmware. Observe the trace showing at stop or start and the resource reserved for M4. Double check when the firmware is running or not using the user 1 button. We have reached here the end of this demonstration. Please find some tips. In particular, note the LAT2 which provide more explanation about the resource sharing between M4 and Linux. Thanks for your attention. We wish you a good experience with the STM32Cube IDE and our STM32MP1 product.